Marjorie Glacier is 250 feet tall, 150 feet below sea level.
Marjorie Glacier was named for a French geologist named Emmanuel de Marjorie, and it is one of the most beautiful glaciers in Glacier Bay. It's a stable glacier, which is unusual in this time of climate warming. Marjorie Glacier is 21 miles long, and it stays 21 miles long. Even though 7 feet of ice fall off the face of that glacier every day, the tall mountains that collect the snow push 7 feet of ice from the top. And all 21 miles of ice grown down through the mountains at a rate of 7 feet every day.
Marjorie Glacier is a showstopper on any given day when you just look at it. And when you look at Marjorie and know that it's about 25 stories tall, then some of the ice that we saw today could have been the size of a 10-story apartment building. And that dramatic, cracking sound it makes, some people call white thunder. It's incredible to experience.
So we're going to be looking for calving, and calving is when the ice breaks off from the glacier and floats in the water and becomes an iceberg.
The glacier buckles and breaks and cracks and almost slams on its brakes, these massive towers piling up behind one another. And to stand in front of the glacier when it calves, you get to hear that sound, that thunder of the ice breaking. And it's almost like it happens in slow motion. Maybe it does, or maybe it's just how exciting it is to see. The Lamplu Glacier pours out of the Brady Ice Field. The Lamplu Glacier is about 16 miles long, and it too is a stable glacier. It stays about the same length. Although the Lamplu Glacier is building up in front of it a pile of rock and mud so that if it were to be given more ice, it might be able to get just a little bit longer. But chances are it will stay the same length because the middle of the inlet in front of the Lamplu Glacier is over 1,200 feet deep. Lamplu Glacier, we nickname Lamplu the Blue, because if each glacier has its own personality and they're also different, Lamplu Glacier really showcases that glacial blue color. And that's a color that's so interesting and complicated. It's a color that comes from how dense glacial ice is. And it takes so much energy for light to travel through that blue is the only color with enough energy to get in and back out and really meet our eyes. So Lamplu Glacier is a fantastic glacier to see some of those things.
Now, normal, all the vessel, all everybody went here, they continue and they go up here. We didn't. We continue across and went inside here to this little point here, which is called John Hopkins. That area, which is the entering to John Hopkins, is closed for the majority of the year because the seal are going there to have baby, and many, many sheep are not allowed to go. Without counting us, only 6,000 people in the world went to John Hopkins. Even some of the ranger has not been there for years, because not all the ranger come on all the ship all the time. You can imagine that is a rare event for them as well. It's very, very special. John Hopkins Glacier is 1 mile wide, is 12 miles long, is 350 feet above the water level. So when we stop and you could see the face of the glacier, if you think to walk that side of the glacier, you have to walk up 350 feet. And it is also 250 feet below the water level. So if you think to take a swim and go to the water level and decide to dive down, before you reach the bottom of the glacier, you have to dive down 250 feet. As you can imagine, water is very, very deep where we stopped. It was more or less 600 feet. So we were very, very safe. Because we couldn't slow down on Marble Island on the way north, we decided to do something that has not been done before. We decided to stop by Marble Island, and we spoke with the ranger, and the ranger were super happy. So we came 1.5 cable off the island and stopped and hold position for 20 minutes in order to allow all of you to enjoy. That's what you, to me, all travel that many miles from home. To see wildlife and to enjoy the nature and everything else. So I thought this would be a little gift from all of us in Star Princess to all of you. You know, something that if you go to anybody that's been on a cruise, even if you've been on a Star before, they will tell you that this is not what is normally get done. This is very, very unique. First time in, even the ranger says no other ship has ever done it before, ever. So I hope you enjoy.
Glacier Bay National Park is an extraordinary place in Southeast Alaska. And all of the things that we hope to see in Southeast Alaska, we can see here. Tidewater glaciers, incredible wildlife, maybe even sunshine on some rare days. And this is a national treasure in the United States here in Alaska.
And we thought to give you something that special for the family. So that's why we decided to go to John Hopkins, and I hope you really, really enjoy, because it's a chance that not many people get to have.
Because you can't help but look at the glaciers and see how hard they have worked to carve the beautiful surrounding around us and how quickly they change from one year to the other. I think that's one of the things that brings people back year after year to Alaska, and specifically to Glacier Bay, is how quickly things are changing and how unique every single week of observation all summer long is.
You get to see the community of nature doing what it does best. People love coming here, and often people come back.
And nevertheless, bye-bye.
For time lay by the sea. if you ever wondered what the world was like when it was emerging from the grip of huge glaciers of the past, Glacier Bay provides a unique look into what a lot of our world looked like at the end of the last great ice age. It's a place that's still partially gripped by those icy forces.
Glacier Bay is very much about the forces that formed most of the North American landscape and really understanding how that works, because you're seeing it right before your eyes. You're still seeing active glaciers carving out valleys, calving icebergs, and then you see where the land has actually rebounded from the weight of the ice after it melts. So I was just really affected by the lessons that Glacier Bay teaches.
It's our home. It's where we were born. It's who we are. It's how we came about. It's how we lived. It's how we grew to adapt. And it's our almost a parent of sorts. It's been our caretaker. It's provided for us and protected us. And even now, as it beckons us to return, it needs us, it wants us.
John Muir once said of glaciers, "The master builder chose for a tool, not the earthquake and lightning to split and rend asunder, not the stormy torrent of rain, but instead a tender snowflake falling noiselessly through unnumbered centuries." Thinking of the little snowflakes that are piling up on those mountains and will one day become glacial ice and carve this bay. Thinking about that kind of reminds you of your place in the world here.
We decide to do something special, something again that no many ship do or has been done before. Not only went to Magic Glacier, but we decide to go and spend some time in John Hopkins. During the 2016, only 4 ships in the world went, and the Starling Sand went twice. So only 6,000 to 7,000 people before us entered John Hopkins in 2016 in the world, not on Princess Cruises, in the world. It's very, very special.
For people coming to Glacier Bay for the first time, there are a myriad of responses. Some people want to know more about it. Some people want to know the measurements, how deep, how tall, how wide, how long. But other people are just struck by the awe of the beauty of this place. I have seen entire cruise ships reduced to whispers when they have seen the majesty of these mountains and glaciers that come down to the sea. Only 250 years ago, what you will see today was not here. There was no water, there were no trees, there were no islands. This was all ice.
Thousands of feet of ice above you. And fact, if you look off the side of the ship, you look up to the mountains, you'll see that they're rounded over at the top, which means the glacier went right on over us as we're sitting in Tar Inlet.
Glacier Bay was founded first as a national monument in 1925, and it took a lot of work to protect this place. The first person to really stand up for it was, of all things, a plant scientist. William Skinner Cooper came here, and he saw that Glacier Bay was a living laboratory. For him, he knew he could study plants here, but the Ecological Society of America, when he presented his findings, they knew that we could probably study so much more. In 1925, we were established as a national monument, and then later, in 1980, we became a national park.
So as we continue our passage on up through, get to enjoy the wildlife along the way, we see the mountains get higher and higher, more snow-capped mountains, and we enter into Tar Inlet. Tar Inlet is a narrower passageway, truly a fjord. Definition of a fjord is that you have steep mountains on both sides, U-shaped valley cut by a glacier and filled with salt water.
So we came in Cape Spencer and we entered in, and it was a bit of a fog, so I had to be on the bridge earlier rather than later. We then went to Barley Cove. Here is where we pick up our ranger, and we went in, and our goal was to go to this little island that is low at 5 knots. It's called Marble Island, where you get to, you know, normally we cruise by at 5 knots and you get to see the sea lion, but it was covered with fog, so we had to abort, which I want to cry, but that's a different point. So we decided to go to Margery Glacier and see Mount Fairweather on the other side.
As we continue on up in the Tar Inlet, our focus will change to the port side, where we see beautiful white Margery Glacier appearing. Margery Glacier is 250 feet tall, 150 feet below sea level.
Margery Glacier was named for a French geologist named Emmanuel de Margery, and it is one of the most beautiful glaciers in Glacier Bay. It's a stable glacier, which is unusual in this time of climate warming. Margery Glacier is 21 miles long, and it stays 21 miles long. Even though 7 feet of ice fall off the face of that glacier every day, the tall mountains that collect the snow push 7 feet of ice from the top. And all 21 miles of ice groan down through the mountains at a rate of 7 feet every day.
Margery Glacier is a showstopper on any given day when you just look at it. And when you look at Margery and know that it's about 25 stories tall, then some of the ice that we saw today could have been the size of a 10-story apartment building. And that dramatic cracking sound it makes, some people call white thunder. It's incredible to experience.
So we're going to be looking for calving, and calving is when the ice breaks off from the glacier and floats in the water and becomes an iceberg.
The glacier buckles and breaks and cracks and almost slams on its brakes, these massive towers piling up behind one another. to stand in front of a glacier when it calves, you get to hear that sound, that thunder of the ice breaking. And it's almost like it happens in slow motion. Maybe it does, or maybe it's just how exciting it is to see. The Lamplugh Glacier pours out of the Brady Ice Field. The Lamplugh Glacier is about 16 miles long, and it too is a stable glacier. It stays about the same length. Although the Lamplugh Glacier is building up in front of it a pile of rock and mud so that if it were to be given more ice, it might be able to get just a little bit longer. But chances are it will stay the same length because the middle of the inlet in front of the Lamplugh Glacier is over 1,200 feet deep. Lamplugh Glacier, we nickname Lamplugh the Blue, because if each glacier has its own personality, and they're also different, Lamplugh Glacier really showcases that glacial blue color. And that's a color that's so interesting and complicated. It's a color that comes from how dense glacial ice is. And it takes so much energy for light to travel through that blue is the only color with enough energy to get in and back out and really meet our eyes. So Lamplugh Glacier is a fantastic glacier to see some of those things.
Now, normal, all the vessel, all everybody went here, they continue and they go up here. We didn't. We continue across and went inside here to this little point here, which is called John Hopkins. That area, which is the entering to John Hopkins, is closed for the majority of the year because the seal are going there to have baby, and many ships are not allowed to go. Without counting us, only 6,000 people in the world went to John Hopkins. Even some of the ranger has not been there for years because not all the ranger come on all the ship all the time. You can imagine that is a rare event for them as well. It's very, very special. John Hopkins Glacier is 1 mile wide, is 12 miles long, is 350 feet above the water level. So when we stop and you could see the face of the glacier, if you think to walk that side of the glacier, you have to walk up 350 feet. And it is also 250 feet below the water level. So if you think to take a swim and go to the water level and decide to dive down, before you reach the bottom of the glacier, you have to dive down 250 feet. As you can imagine, water is very, very deep where we stopped. It was more or less 600 feet. So we were very, very safe. Because we couldn't slow down on Marble Island on the way north, we decided to do something that, again, has not been done before. We decided to stop like Marble Island. And we spoke with the ranger, and the ranger were super happy. So we came 1.5 cable off the island and stopped and hold position for 20 minutes in order to allow all of you to enjoy. That's what you, to me, all travel that many miles from home for, to see wildlife and to enjoy the nature and everything else. So I thought this would be a little gift from all of us in the Star Princess to all of you. You know, something that if you go to anybody that's been on a cruise, even if you've been on a star before, they will tell you that this is not what is normally get done. This is very, very unique. First time in, even the ranger says, no other ship has ever done before, ever. So I hope you enjoy.
Glacier Bay National Park is an extraordinary place in Southeast Alaska. And all of the things that we hope to see in Southeast Alaska, we can see here. Tidewater glaciers, incredible wildlife, maybe even sunshine on some rare days. And this is a national treasure in the United States here in Alaska.
And we thought to give you something that special for the family. So that's why we decided to go to John Hopkins, and I hope you really, really enjoy, because it's a chance that no many people get to have.
Because you can't help but look at the glaciers and see how hard they have worked to carve the beautiful surrounding around us and how quickly they change from one year to the other. I think that's one of the things that brings people back year after year to Alaska, and specifically to Glacier Bay, is how quickly things are changing and how unique every single week of observation all summer long is.
You get to see the community of nature doing what it does best. People love coming here, and often people come back.
And nevertheless, bye-bye.
See you.